House prices rose by more than 8% over 2013, according to the Nationwide. While every region in the UK saw an increase, London again saw the largest rise. Henry Pryor is a property market expert. He joins me now in the studio. Very good afternoon to you. So if you're a homeowner, very good news. If you're trying to get on the property ladder, not so great.
Absolutely. And it looks like we've got another 12 months through 2014. In fact, 490-odd days ahead of the next general election next year, 2015. And house prices, so the coalition government are intent on doing, putting a foundation under prices to ensure that the value of houses ends the year ahead of where they are even today.
Now, we hear year after year that it's not sustainable house prices, certainly in London. Are we in a bubble in the southeast?
Well, it's very important, you're quite correct, to identify the market being made up of these regional variations. We've got house prices in London and perhaps the southeast of the country running away far faster than they are across the rest of the country. House prices still in the northeast and the northwest, still going backwards in real terms when you factor in inflation. We have to remember that house prices per se are still, when you talk about sale prices, which are recorded by the Land Registry and the Office for National Statistics, still some 10% below the peaks they reached before the credit crunch in 2007-2008. Asking prices are back to where they were. Vendors and estate agents appear to have hit the new year with their tails up and somewhat optimistic about the way the market is looking. So I suspect that we'll find that through 2014 there will be continue to be regional differences. But house prices, as I say, the government are very, very clear. House prices with their various initiatives, they are intent on rising house prices through the remainder of the year.
Yeah, the government are pretty pleased about this with their Help to Buy schemes, aren't they? Let's separate out London and the rest of the country then, because the rest of the country does need that boost, doesn't it, economically? They need house prices to rise.
Well, house prices and rising house prices obviously are a mixed blessing. It's very important to have a stable housing market, and everybody would encourage that. But the new governor of the Bank of England, Mark Carney, has gone on record at the back end of last year, just before Christmas, saying he was keeping very much a watching brief on it. There has been some significant criticism of the government's Help to Buy initiative. They brought to an end the funding for lending scheme that was there to support mortgage lending through 2013. But Help to Buy, we saw from announcements made by the Prime Minister yesterday, they've had 750 Help to Buy two completions. That's the second phase of Help to Buy. It's far too early to suggest that Help to Buy, therefore, is actually helping to ramp house prices. But like Mark Carney, I share the concerns that perhaps Help to Buy longer term will have a demonstrable impact.
OK, Henry Pryor, thank you.